Okay, hi guys, welcome to another bowling review video. So in this video, just like I mentioned in the previous video, if you have watched my review on Jesse Curiel, who is the editor behind Darren Tang's channel and is kind of a beginner, a new two-handed bowler, and he's going through the typical struggles of most new two-handers, most beginner two-handers, which is like lack of ball speed, lack of spare accuracy, couldn't get his swing in line and stuff like that, couldn't get a high enough tempo, right? And in that video, I mentioned that I will do a follow-up video, which is this today, which is we're going to analyze the two-handers from the US who participated in the US team trials recently. And many of these bowlers are really good because they are high-level competitive bowlers and their physical game has reached a certain level where they feel that they should represent Team USA or could represent Team USA, and we will analyze their game and how they get their ball speed and so on. So a lot of these videos, just a big shout out to the video. The video comes from When the Lanes Come On, which is also another fellow small channel, because obviously I'm a small channel as well, and he's done by a fellow two-hander. So, and they have recorded quite a few videos so far. Obviously the upload rate is not as consistent. You'll see that it's probably like once a month and so on. Probably focusing more on like youth tournaments, where I think the channel owner himself is a youth bowler, youth two-handed bowler as well. And this time, because he's participating in the team trials, he's recorded himself and many other fellow two-handers. So thanks to him, we get to see a lot of other fellow two-handers here. And you will see that most of the two-handers featured here have really good ball speed. So I would just measure some of their ball speed, and I would change my display above. So what I'm using to measure ball speed is an app called the 10-pin toolkit. So you can download it from the Apple Store or the Apple Store or the Google Play Store if you're using an Android. And 10-pin toolkit is actually pretty convenient. It has a ball speed timer. So basically, it's just a simple timer for you to time when the ball leaves the foul line. That means basically you press start when your ball crosses the foul line. And then you just now I need to end. I did this. Give me a moment. So that was about 26 earlier for that particular bowler, 26 kilometers per hour. Yep. So basically, press start when the ball crosses the foul line, and then you press stop on the timer when the ball hits the first pin. And then you get your ball speed. So it does the math and the conversion inside there. So earlier bowler was bowling around 26. We have another two-hander here, and we can measure his ball speed. So I think they are bowling on a short pattern, right? Day one man, it's 38 feet. So it's actually medium, but I see quite a lot of urethane being thrown. Okay, so let's measure this bowler's ball speed. Yep, he threw that about 28 to 30 kilometers per hour. Let's time his ball speed again. So it's a bit faster because he is throwing a much straighter line. Yeah, that's 30 kilometers per hour, right? So another two-hander here. So let's update that. So the earlier shot was 30 kilometers per hour. This particular bowler. Yep, so there's 30 kilometers per hour. But this Jack Person. Okay, let's time it. Let's kind of reverse again for Jack. And let's time his ball speed. Okay. Yep, that's 27.7 kilometers per hour. So let's update that. 27. Okay, that's 27 kilometers per hour. Okay, so I'm just going to skip the one-handers. Just going to focus on two-handed bowlers in this video. Okay, another bowler. Solomon Salama is kind of like a regular in the US team trials and in youth team USA as well. A very, very good two-handed lefty. So let's time his ball speed. Yep, 25.5. Let's reverse again. I'll reverse a little bit more. Yep, 26. So about 25 to 26. Solomon Salama is about 26 kilometers per hour. Okay, so there's a one-hander featured here. Okay, and I think, yeah, Mika Voris is actually the owner of this YouTube channel. And let's see Mika's ball speed. Okay, so Mika is averaging about 27.5 kilometers per hour, right? So 27.5 kilometers per hour for his two-handed ball speed. This is a one-hander. Yep, one-hander as well. But he's also averaging about there, about 30 kilometers per hour, I believe, based on a quick estimate. That's Nick Pate. Nick Pate should be averaging about 27, 28 kilometers per hour in my estimate. James Burnett, is that two-hander? Okay, so James is two-hander as well. So let's measure his ball speed. Okay. His pocket, that's about 27.9 for James Burnett. So about 28 actually. About 28 kilometer per hour. Okay, another two-hander. So let's measure his ball speed. Right, gonna time it as it goes through the foul line. 31, I believe I started my timer a little bit late. Okay, let's try a better job. Yep, still about 29.8. Right, so that's easily 30 kilometers per hour. Right, 30 kilometers per hour. So as I go through, okay, we have another here, Rylan Breeze. I believe he's a friend as of the channel as well. That's why his name is featured in the editing here. Okay. We need to time his ball speed for Rylan. Okay, so Rylan threw that at 30 kilometers per hour. So as we've gone through quite a few bowlers so far, you will notice a very similar trend. All of them have ball speeds that are at least 26 kilometers per hour to 30 kilometers per hour. If you convert it to miles per hour, if you are a viewer from the US, that will be easily 17 to 18 miles per hour. So that is the so-called ball speed that you need to hit in order to be competitive at the national level, in this case US team trials, or at the international level if you're representing USA to bowl overseas, if you're going for overseas tournaments and so on. So you have to hit this level of ball speed if you want to like average high enough to hit. So this is, I think, the slowest ball speed that I've seen in the US team trials here. Let's time this. Let's time again. Yep. So for him, it's still about 26, right? For both here, this guy is still throwing at 26. 26.7 actually from my timer here. So it's still at least 27 kilometers per hour. So Mika, we know he's throwing like 30 kilometers per hour. Yep. So the ball speed is kind of essential, right? And we have Joshua, I guess. Let's time his ball speed. Yep, 31. Joshua threw that at about 30 to 31 kilometers per hour. So yeah, it's a very similar trend. I think I could kind of rest my case here. Is that for all these high level two-handers, competitive two-handers, they're throwing at a high ball speed, like at least 26 to somewhere in the range of like 30, 31 kilometers per hour, which is about 16 to 18 miles per hour. That is the ball speed you have to hit. So maybe we can analyze them a little bit. And yeah, we have Brandon Bourne as well and featured in the video. We can analyze these bowlers a little bit to see what are their secrets to generating a high ball speed. So for Brendan Bond, he's actually one of the bowlers who has the smoothest footwork and the smoothest swing. Among all the so-called younger two-handers, Brendan himself, I think, is close to 21, is above 18, if I'm not wrong, I'm not super sure. So what you will notice, a common trend that, maybe you've not noticed it yet, but what I've noticed is that let's just take a look at Brendan's ball speed as well. Okay, crosses the ball like that, hits the pocket at 28, right? Even for Brendan, it's still no slouch. Obviously, he is one of the most well-known two-handed youth bowlers out in the US right now. And he's no slouch. He's averaging 28 kilometers per hour with his ball speed. So Brendan has a pretty smooth approach. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You'll notice that their last three steps are pretty fast. Let's look at Brendan's one here. Like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yep. So a common trend you'll notice that their last three steps are pretty fast and their swing speed is pretty fast as well. So when he goes down for a swing, no, the swing takes, does it take a second to complete? 1,000, 2,000, yep. So it takes 1 second for the backswing, another second for the forward swing. And we're going to see more youth two-handed, more two-handers here, Mika again. Okay. Now Mika has a pretty unorthodox style. 11 in a row, obviously doing really, really good in day one. So what Mika does is, if you take a look at his style, okay, he's kind of blocked here. Maybe we can get a better shot at Mika. Do I have a better shot, Mika, here? One, two. Yep. Yeah, this is the best we can do because there's always somebody blocking him. Is that you notice that actually Mika here, he holds on to the ball for the first two steps. Okay, so this is the beginning of his first step. And let's forward again. So we go frame by frame. His second step, he's still holding on to the ball. Notice that he hasn't placed his ball at all in the first two steps. So he's only going to place his ball at the beginning of his third step. So he's going to delay his ball placement timing from the typical placement of placing a ball in the second step of your five-step approach. So for most one-handers, they typically place it on the second step of the five-step approach. And for modern two-handers, I would advise them to delay it by a whole step and kind of place it at the end of the second step or even the beginning of your third step to not delay it considerably. So you can see Mika here for the first two steps. No, he's walking his second step. And he still hasn't moved his ball yet, right? So this is second step. You can see his right foot going forward. And he's only going to move his ball at the beginning of the third step, which is blocked by a fellow bowler here. But he's actually delaying his ball placement by a whole step. He's only moving his ball at the beginning of his third step, right? And his backswing is typically pretty fast. Let's take a look. 2, 3, 1,000. Yeah. His backswing doesn't even take 1 second to complete. 1,000, 2,000. Yeah. His backswing and forward swing is actually a bit faster than Brendan Bond's because he does have that bent arm swing when he swings to the back. But you can see he's really fast. It's like he makes his backswing really short and then he goes for the forward swing. And the forward swing only takes about less than 1 second to complete. 1,000, 2,000. Yep. So his forward swing takes about less than 1 second to complete and the ball is already out on the lanes. So the speed of their swing is really important. Speed of the footwork, speed of the swing. We have more two-handed bowlers here. So we can take a look at another two-handed bowler. In this case, I can't see his name here. So we're gonna... Griffin? Okay. We only have his last few steps. Okay, so this is not his full approach. But this particular, I think Joshua Collins, right? Joshua Collins, a left-hander, is going to his third step here. Third, fourth, and fifth. And you can see that the height of their backswing is also not too high as well. So this is actually a myth for two-handers who have a high backswing. Like the modern two-handers, or at least the competitive ones, even for Carl Troop, actually they don't have a really high backswing. They actually keep their backswing to the height of their hips, right? So their backswing, especially if you have a straight swing like Joshua here, I believe his name is Joshua Collins, If I'm not wrong, did I get his name correct? Wait, let me reverse it and kind of look at his shirt at the back. Yeah, Joshua. Like Joshua here, if you're a bowler with a straight backswing, take note to not have your backswing go beyond your hips. Yep, because if you go beyond your hips with a straight arm swing here, it's very difficult for the other non-bowling arm to be, you know, to get under the ball, to stay under the ball. So in order to do that, you have to keep your backswing short. So to keep your backswing to the level of your hips, yeah, that's the maximum height that you should go. And obviously, you want to keep it fast as well. So if we're going to time Joshua's backswing speed here. Yep, so his backswing is so fast, right? Yeah, I can't even time it. It's too fast. His forward swing only takes about 1 second. Let me time his forward swing. 1,000. 1,000. Yep. Yeah, his forward swing is way too fast. He took less than a second to have his arm swing to go from the top of his arm swing to his release. So that's like a split second for his forward swing to finish. 1,000, 2,000. So Brandon, we have already timed it. So there's Mika again. So a common theme is very quick backswing and forward swing. Very fast last three steps. 3, 4, 5. Okay. So let's take a look at his footwork here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you notice the quick last three steps. So the first two steps are kind of slow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. A little bit faster on the last three steps. And this, so for this particular bowler, his backswing is a little bit on the higher end. Right. So this is one of the rare instances where his backswing goes a lot higher than his hips. So what I mean by high is that it goes a lot higher than the two-handed bowler's hips. So that'll be considered a high backswing. But still, for a high backswing, he still has a pretty fast swing speed. So let's time his backswing and his forward swing. 1,000, 2,000. Yep. So his backswing took 1 second and his forward swing took about less than a second. And that high swing speed is actually how these two enders. Oh, we have Caltrip here. So if you take a look at Caltrip's height of his backswing. So let's take a look. Caltrip, current pro, PBA pro. So you notice Caltrip's backswing also doesn't exceed his hips, right? Let me use blue here because Caltrip is wearing red. So you notice that the height of Caltrip's backswing, because he's using the straight arm swing approach, doesn't go beyond his hips, right? So yeah, in order for his non-bowling arm, which is his left arm, to stay under the ball enough, you cannot have your backswing go beyond your hips, especially if you're using the straight elbow backswing. If you are using with the bent elbow backswing, yes, your backswing could go a little bit higher, but still the speed of the backswing and the speed of the forward swing is very important. Let's take a look at Caltrip again. Let's time his backswing to 1,000, 2,000. Yep. So from back to forward, his backswing still takes about 1 second to complete. 1,000, 2,000. Yeah, his forward swing actually takes less than 1 second to complete. 1,000, 2,000. Yep. So really less than a second. So their swing takes less than a second to complete. Yep. And this is an extreme here where you can see how speed his last three step is for this particular right-handed bowler, Ryland, I believe. 1, 2. So you can see that he really shuffles and speed up his last three steps. Last three steps goes really fast. His backswing occurs so fast. He has a bent backswing. Like, it doesn't even take a half a second to complete his backswing. Like, I can't even count it. Like, 1,000. 1,000, 2,000. Like, I think like his entire backswing and forward swing only took like 1.5 seconds to complete. And that's how he's able to generate such a high ball speed. And the amazing thing is that he's not a very big guy, right? So you can see Ryland here is pretty small build. He's only around this height, and we can see Preston here is like a whole head and shoulders taller than Ryland. But yet Ryland is still able to generate that high ball speed with the use of his quick backswing. So the speed of his swing and the speed of his last three step is what's giving him that high ball speed. Yeah, and earlier we measured Ryland's ball speed is about 30 kilometers per hour. So this is an example of a slow ball speed bowler. So we have Garrett Andrews here. So Andrew, you can see, let's time his ball speed here. Let's play the video. Okay, 23.9. So Garrett is obviously trying to shape it a little bit. He's throwing a little bit slower. But you can see as a comparison, why Garrett's ball speed is a little bit slower is because he's taking his time with his three steps. He's actually like slowing down the step into the slide. 1,000, 2,000. And you can see his forward swing is a lot slower. His backswing is pretty fast, 1,000. His backswing is kind of slow as well. We can see here as he goes to the top, he kind of pauses a little before he starts his downswing. And as he pauses a little, his downswing also takes time to complete. Like 1,000, 2,000. Yep. So pretty slow, like slow. So the speed of the swing and the speed of the last three steps is in direct correlation to your ball speed. So that's why Garrett here is like averaging around 24 kilometers per hour, which is a lot slower than the norm here. But obviously he's still a really good bowler. He threw a really nice, well-shaped shot there. Right, he probably can throw fast if he wants to. He's probably intentionally slowing down his ball speed because he wants his ball to pick up and get that desired shape on the lane. Oh, we have Chris Vai here. Chris Vai. So Chris Vai has pretty slow footwork, right? Let's time his ball speed here. Yep, about 26 kilometers per hour for Chris Vai here. So 26. Obviously not too fast, but like I mentioned, some of them, they can throw fast if they want to, but they're intentionally slowing it down because they want their ball to pick up and get a certain shape of the lane to get that carry into the pocket. So let's see how Chris Vai actually slows down instead. Let's check his backswing speed. Yeah, you can see Chris's backswing speed is kind of a bit on the slower end. 1,000, 2,000. His forward swing is also slower as well. Yep, and that's why his ball speed is a little bit on the slower end for this particular shot. But Chris can go fast if he wants to. Yep, there's a one-hander. So one-handers, competitive one-handers here are also easily averaging around 26 to 30. That's, I forgot his name actually. Chris Prater. That's Chris Prater. Okay. So I think that's about it. Now he's featuring all the... Yeah, we have Spencer Robach, which is also a frequent occupant of the US... how should I say it? Like, he always gets the team... He's always representing US for the youth spot. So he's a frequent occupant of the youth spot for Team USA. And let's take a look at his ball speed, Spencer Robach. Yeah, Spencer Robach has threw that about 29.3 kilometers per hour. So that's 29 there. So 29 kilometers per hour for Spencer Robach. Pretty fast. So let's take a look at how Spencer speeds it up, right? 1, 2. So he kind of notice that his first two steps are really slow. So they take their time with their first two steps. Spencer actually moves his ball in the beginning of the second step, right? So we're going back frame by frame. Okay, so you can see 1, 2. So you can see this is the beginning of second step and Spencer has already moved his ball. So he has a little bit of an early timing with his ball placement. But the essential thing is still that on the last three steps, he kind of pushes his ball out so that his swing takes a little bit more time to complete. So he pushes his ball upwards so that it takes more time on the upswing, on the ball placement. 4, 5. Okay, let's look at his backswing speed again. So his last three step is obviously decently quick. Swing speed, 1,000, 2,000. His forward swing speed is a little bit faster. 1,000, 2,000. His backswing is not too fast, 1,000. See again, 1,000, 2,000, yep. So it takes about 1 second to complete his backswing and another second to complete the forward swing. So it's still getting a really high ball speed there. There's another Team USA member. I forgot his name, but yes, also pretty decent ball speed. Let's measure his ball speed as well. So obviously representing Team DV8. That's a lot slower than I thought. I measured 25. Yep, that's 26. That's a lot slower than I thought. So how he gets his ball speed? Mostly on the forward swing. This forward swing is a little bit faster. The backswing is kind of a little bit on the slower end. But one thing to note is that for the straight backswing, for if you're having a straight elbowed backswing, notice that you're not swinging the ball higher than your hips, right? You want to keep the ball close to your hip level so that the non-bowling arm can stay underneath the ball enough. Yep, in this case, his backswing is going a little bit high. Okay, so that's about it. So this video has gone for about 26 minutes. So to summarize, some of the keys for two-handed ball speed is the speed of your last three steps and the speed of your downswing and forward swing. So the faster you can make it, like the speed of your downswing, if you can complete the speed of your downswing in less than a second and the speed of your forward swing until you release the ball is less than a second as well, typically you should be able to generate pretty quick ball speed. And obviously you need to have fast footwork for your last three steps to accommodate that high swing speed as well. Then for newer two-handed bowlers, if you're not used to starting a ball on the second step, I would suggest to change your ball placement timing to delay it and to place your ball at the end of the second step or even the beginning of your third step, right? So delay it by an entire first step, so that it takes less time to complete, and it just gives you higher swing speed. Higher swing speed, higher ball speed as well. Okay, so thank you guys for watching. We will see you guys next time.